there's two different solutions. And we mix them together, and a solid is formed. Now, one is an aqueous solution of silver nitrate, and the other one is an aqueous solution of sodium chloride. As far as the product, what's the product? That's what we need to do in this section. You need to be able to write out equations that describe the formation of that product. And these are called metathesis reactions, which means change. Let's take a look at what's inside each of the test tubes. So what ions are in silver nitrate? Well, silver ion and nitrate ion. But you got to write them properly with their charges. So going back to what we learned earlier when we studied ionic compounds, names and formulas of them. So not explicitly writing the waters in, but this is a way to look at an aqueous solution of silver nitrate. You have silver ions and you have nitrate ions in there. We can do the same thing with an aqueous sodium chloride solution. You have chloride ions and sodium ions in there. Now we throw them all together. And this is what we have before any allowed reaction happens. As if we could mix them together and then freeze everything. So we have a lot of silver ions, a lot of nitrate ions, chloride, and sodium ions floating around in there. So if there's going to be a product, it has to be between oppositely charged ions. You can't put cations together and you can't put anions together. Well, why can't you? Well, because they have the same charge. You have to have opposite charges. And we know that silver nitrate and sodium chloride are soluble, even completely ignoring solubility rules, because you saw the test tubes with them and they were soluble. So one possible product could be formed by the combination of silver and chloride ions. Another possible product can be formed from sodium and nitrate ions. Now what we want to do is write out a number of different chemical equations that describe the process in various levels of detail. So let's do that. So here are my reactants. Then what I'm going to do is write them out in name form first. All right, so what was the name of this? I know we had it previously, but humor me. It's silver nitrate. Going back to what you learned when learning how to write the names and formula of ionic compounds. What's this one? Sodium chloride. Now, when I teach these metathesis reactions, I strongly encourage people to not look at that as AgNO3 plus NaCl. Look at it in terms of the names, silver nitrate plus sodium chloride. It will help you. So the potential products will be, see how I didn't write nitrate sodium? Cation followed by anion. One possible product is sodium nitrate. And another possible product is silver chloride. Now we have three different chemical equations we're going to write. I'm going to walk through each of the three, and then afterwards come back and talk about the significance of each of the equations. So first, the molecular equation, which is really not labeled properly because these are not molecules, they're ionic compounds, but many of the books call this equation the molecular equation. Think of it as the balanced and equation that has the proper state labels in it also. Excuse me. So let's write each chemical formula from the name. Proper charges, silver ions plus 1, nitrates minus 1. What about this one? Sodium ions plus 1, chloride ion is minus 1. Sodium nitrate. Cation first, anion second, plus 1, minus 1 on the charges. And how do we write silver chloride? Plus 1, minus 1 on the charges. Now we're not finished. We have to balance it, then we have to put in the proper state labels. All these reactions in this section are being done in water. What do we have to do to balance it? Okay, yeah, it's already balanced. That's because all the ion charges are either plus or minus 1. Don't depend upon that always happening. State labels. We've gone through the solubility rules. So if it's ionic and soluble, you put an AQ for the state label. It means it dissolves in water, aqueous. If it's ionic and insoluble, you put an S for insoluble. It stays as a solid. Nitrates are soluble. AQ. Group 1A compounds are soluble. Put an AQ. Now when you look at the products, you follow the same procedure. Group 1A compounds are soluble. AQ. Chlorides, bromides, and iodides are soluble, with three common exceptions. Silver ion is one of the exceptions, so that gets an S. Now, the total ionic equation, sometimes called the ionic equation, takes all the compounds and breaks them apart into ions whenever appropriate. What does it mean to have an aqueous solution of silver nitrate? Well, it means you have aqueous silver ions and aqueous nitrate ions. An aqueous solution of sodium chloride means you have aqueous sodium ions and aqueous chloride ions. And when we go to the products, you don't really think of them as products yet, because we're just going through the procedure. An aqueous solution of sodium nitrate is aqueous sodium ions and aqueous nitrate ions. Now, this is a solid, so it stays together in solution primarily as a solid. So we leave it alone. The net ionic equation. What you do for this is you go back to the total ionic equation and you remove any spectator ions. Spectator ions are those that are in both the reactant and the product, and they're not involved in the reaction. It's like having a mathematical equation. If you have X on both sides of the equal sign, you can subtract X. So in the total ionic equation, we have nitrate in the reactant, nitrate in the product. Sodium ion in the reactant, sodium ion in the product. We cannot remove silver ion because its silver ion is a reactant, but it's in silver chloride solid as a product. So now we bring down what remains. We have silver ion and we have chloride ion. And those react to form silver chloride solid. A common test for chloride ion in water is to add a little bit of silver nitrate and see if you make a kind of an ivory-colored precipitate. And let's go back to each of these. The benefit to the molecular equation is it gives, I guess you can think of it as a big picture look at it. You take a solution of silver nitrate and sodium chloride, mix them together, you'll make silver chloride solid. But in the product, the sodium nitrate is not really a product. So that's a little misleading on the molecular equation. Sodium nitrate really exists as sodium ions and nitrate ions. The total ionic equation has a lot of information in it. If you look at the reactant side, it tells you all of the ions that are available to react. If you look at the product side, it tells you what did react. In other words, you make silver chloride solid. But then it also tells you what didn't react, sodium ion and nitrate ion. And then the net ionic equation gets right down to what happens and take away anything that's not involved in the reaction. So if you take an aqueous solution that has silver ion in it and an aqueous solution that has chloride ion in it, you expect a precipitate to form. But the net ionic equation leaves out the other ions, the co-ions. In other words, what was silver ion combined with? Well, in this case, we don't care as long as we get silver ion. The chloride ion, what was with chloride ion? Well, in this case, we don't care as long as we have chloride ion. If you see a precipitate, then you must have a net ionic equation that shows the formation of a solid.